Robot Animator is a plugin for Autodesk Maya that enables users to animate real robots the same way they animate characters in animation. I'm a classically trained computer animator, and when I first met robots in the mid-90s, there was a definite correlation between what I do as a computer animator and what folks are doing programming robots. There was this correlation, and I said, can I jump from being a computer animator, extolling motion onto 3D CAD wireframes to make them seem organic, or add the dimension of time? So once we were able to do Robot Animator, it made the computer animator now a robot animator. So that's why we called it Robot Animator.
We have a little piece of technology, EntertainTech, that makes it very easy for Andy's application to plug into our controller and give him a time-based functionality. So we actually, with that, create a path table, which is joint moves rather than point-to-point moves of the robot, which we can move the robot very synchronously and very smoothly. So we can plug in lighting systems, sound, other peripheral devices into the robot program when it's developed out of animation to synchronize the complete effect.
This is a KUKA KR10 Agilis robot. It's comprised of six axes, which means six areas that it rotates in. And what KUKA has done here is what's called biomimicry. It's mimicking my arm and how my arm moves. I have six axes in my arm, and this robot also has six axes. This is axis one. This is axis two. Right here is axis three, four. Five is like my wrist. And six is also like my wrist, like this here. So what the robot's doing with the six axes, it's trying to come to a solution like my arm is. So if I want to reach out and pick up a mug, I'm not thinking 4 degrees, 12 degrees, 6 degrees, individual axes. I'm just thinking where my hand is going. And my brain is calculating the math to keep my wrist straight. It's called inverse kinematics. So inverse kinematics is different than forward kinematics. And forward kinematics is where I'm rotating individual axes at one time. Now, this may be something that might be useful doing programming in forward kinematics, but our program, Robot Animator, employs inverse kinematics, which comes from computer animation and how they make characters squash and stretch when they walk. What I want to do is we're going to go over to Robot Animator, and I'm going to show you how inverse kinematics works in Robot Animator. This is Robot Animator. It's a plugin that runs inside Autodesk Maya, and it creates a panel inside Maya that's specific to robot programming. So here I have a KUKA KR10 Agilis, and I'm going to demonstrate to you how inverse kinematics moves. So you can see I can just grab the nose of the robot and move it around, and see how it's pulling the robot wherever I want to go? So it's calculating all of the different six axes, their rotations automatically based on how I rotate the nose of the robot. So this again is inverse kinematics. So when I program something, I'm just pulling them around and setting keyframes. So you can see it's calculating all of those moves just based on how I'm rotating the nose of the robot. You're going to see robots as much of a part as motion pictures, as much as a part of TV, as much as a part of any type of live entertainment, just the way computer animation has just totally proliferated everything in entertainment in a way that you just accept now. Robots will become part of the vocabulary of stagecraft, from Broadway to television to motion picture production, you name it.
I think there's a lot of opportunities out there, and all that technology is coming forward right now, and it's all leading to ease of use. Robots have traditionally been, you need to go have training, you need to maybe have an engineering degree to work on a robot. With what we're doing with Andy, it's just so simple. If you know how to animate, you can program a robot. And it just opens the door for a whole realm of new applications. Orange Intelligenz.